Your Gmail inbox, it's overflowing again. At least that's what used to happen to mine. But what if Gmail could actually do the work for you? Organize your messages, prioritize what matters, even create to-dos automatically. Today, I'll show you 5 advanced Gmail tips and tricks that go beyond the basics. By the end, you'll have a cleaner, faster inbox, and Gmail will finally feel like it's working for you. Hi, I'm Kevin, and let's dive in. One of the best ways to take control of your inbox is by turning it into a dashboard where every single email has a clear next step. Let's set up 3 simple labels: follow-up, waiting on, and read later. Follow-up is for messages that need your action. Waiting on is for emails you've already replied to, but you're waiting for someone else. And lastly, read later. This is for newsletters or non-urgent messages you want to revisit when maybe you have a little bit more time. To create these, over on the left-hand side, you'll see a category for labels. Let's click on the plus icon, and here I can type in the name of my first label. I'll call this follow-up, and then click on create. And right there, we see the first label. Let's add 2 more. I'll click on the plus icon, and this one is waiting on. I'll click on create, and then the plus icon once more. And for this one, I'll call it read later, and then click on create. And there we now have our 3 labels. Now that we have all of these different labels, I want to set up a view that'll show me all of the different messages within each one of these different labels or categories. To do that, go up to the top right-hand corner and click on the settings gear, and then scroll down just a little bit and you'll see a category called inbox type. Let's turn on the one titled multiple inboxes, then scroll down a little bit more and let's click on customize. This drops us into settings, and right here you'll see a category for multiple inbox sections. We can define what these different sections should be. I want each section to be one of the labels that I just created. So over here we need to type in a search query. I'll start with label colon, and then I'll type in the first label's name, follow-up. To the right of that, I could also type in a friendly section name. So here I'll type in follow-up, and then I'll do the same for the next 2 sections. So over here, I'll type in label, waiting on, and here the friendly name is waiting on. Again, label colon, and here read later, and then for the section name, I'll type in read later. Right down here, you can also choose the multiple inbox position, so where it appears on the screen, to the right of the inbox, above the inbox, or below the inbox. I personally like it to the right, so I'll select this, but to each their own. If we scroll down a little bit more, let's click on the button that says Save Changes. This brings us back into the inbox. Right over here, I see all of my inbox messages, and over on the right-hand side, I can see all of the new sections that we just established. Within the center, you could adjust the view, so you could give more or less space to all of the new sections. Now, we can start assigning these different messages to the new sections. So let's start going through a few of the messages. I'll click into the first one, and here it looks like Patty has updated the production schedule, and she wants me to review and confirm the new quantities. Oh, that sounds like an action on me. So over here, I'll go back. Now I could take this email message and I'll drag it over to one of these labels. Now that's a follow-up, so I'll release right there. You'll notice that it removes it from my inbox and it now places it within the follow-up category. Here I see a message from Diego, and it looks like he's going to send me updated thumbnails by tomorrow morning. So it sounds like there's an action on him. So there's nothing for me to follow up on. The bad thing though is sometimes Diego forgets to follow up. So over here, I'll take his message and let's add it to waiting on. That way I could check tomorrow morning just to make sure that he actually responds to that message. Oh, there's the Kevin Cookie Company newsletter. While I certainly love reading it and it has lots of good information, I don't have the time to look at it right now. So that's something I'll add to read later. Over here, I could take this message, let's drag it down and I'll place it into read later. And there, I now have messages showing up in these different sections. I'll now go through and add the rest of these messages to these different categories. And look at that, every email now has a home. My inbox over here is empty, and I now have a clear overview of what's actionable, what's pending, and what can wait. Every morning, I start at the top of my follow-up list, and I work my way down. Now, once you complete an item, simply click into it, and right up on top, you can see the label that we applied, follow up. So let's say I finish this item right over here. I can turn this off, and that removes it from my follow up list. If I go back to the inbox, you'll see that it's no longer here. If I'd like to review the items that I've completed over on the left hand side, we could click into the all mail category, and here I see all of my different messages. Wouldn't it be great if Gmail could automatically turn your emails into tasks? That way, you never forget to follow up again. Whenever I label an email as follow up, I want a new task to be created automatically in Todoist, where I happen to manage everything that I need to get done. I teamed up with Zapier to show you how easy it is to connect Gmail to Todoist, or really to just about any other app you use. And it's also free to start using. Here on the Zapier website, you'll see the Copilot box. I could simply type what app I want to connect to Gmail in plain language. So let's test this out. When I label an email follow up in Gmail, creates a task in Todoist with the email subject and a link to that email. You can try this exact automation yourself using the link in the pinned comment down below. Once you enter it in, right over here, I'll click on send. Here, I can see a quick view of the proposed system, and this all looks good to me. So down below, let's continue with Zap Editor. Copilot instantly builds this workflow for me, connecting Gmail right here to Todoist. And it just took a few seconds. Now, when I click into Gmail, right up on top, I can click into configure. Right over here, it's searching for the label follow up. And right over here, we can now test to see if it finds some messages with that label. Down below, let's test the trigger. It looks like it found a few different messages with that label. So let's go with email C and then continue with the selected record. When it finds an email with that label, it'll then create a new task. Let's click on continue. Here, it'll create a task with the title that matches the email subject, and down below, it'll include details related to that message. That looks great. Over here, I'll click on continue, and now we can test it out to make sure that it's working as we expect it to. Here I am now in Todoist, and look at that. I now have a new task based on a Gmail message. Let's now jump back to Zapier. Now that we confirmed it works, in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on publish. Now, whenever I label an email as follow-up in Gmail, it automatically appears in Todoist as a new task that I can check off later. It's one of those small automations that quietly saves you time every single day. And once you set it up, it just works. And the best part is, this same approach works with thousands of other apps. You can use Zapier to save certain emails to a Google spreadsheet, or generate Gmail drafts automatically with ChatGPT, or send a WhatsApp notification just for certain Gmails. Now, those are just a few examples of the different connections Zapier allows you to make. It's free to set up a Zapier account, so give it a shot. Gmail filters are one of those features that most people overlook, but once you set them up, your inbox basically runs itself. Let's start with a simple but powerful one, making sure you never miss important messages from your boss or key contacts. Right up on top, let's click on this icon for search options. And under the from field, type in your boss's email address. My boss is Patty Fernandez. I'll click on her name right there. Then down in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on create filter. And when we do that, we have all these different options. Now right over here, I can star the message. And if we look down a little bit more, I could also mark it as important. And I think all these look good for now. So in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on create filter. Now, when I receive a message from my manager, Patty, it'll automatically star it and also mark it as important. So that way it stands out a little bit more in my inbox. Also, over on the left-hand side, if I click into starred, here I see all my messages from Patty, or I could also click into important, and here too, I also see messages from Patty. Let's now go back to the main inbox, and next we're going to do the opposite. We're going to reduce the noise. When I worked in Microsoft, I used this all the time, and it helped me cut down on so much email. You can automatically archive emails where you're not directly on the to or the CC line. Let's go up to the search box on top and again, click on search options. Right down here, let's go down to doesn't have and type in to:me or CC:me. Then in the bottom right hand corner, let's click on create filter. For all these messages, let's skip the inbox and automatically archive it. Then in the bottom right hand corner, click on create filter. This keeps all of those mass emails and notifications searchable, but out of sight in your primary inbox. And if you ever need to tweak or remove a filter, go up to the top right-hand corner, click on the settings gear, and then click on See All Settings. In the center of the screen, let's click on Filters and Blocked Addresses, and here you'll see all the different filters that you've created. You can edit, delete, or export them from here. We've all sent an email too quickly. Maybe you forgot an attachment, or maybe hit reply all by mistake. I know, it's happened to me. Gmail actually gives you a built-in safety net for that, and it's called Undo Send. To turn it on, go up to the top right-hand corner and click on the settings gear, and then see all settings. Make sure you're in the general tab, and then look for an option that says Undo Send. Here, you can choose how long Gmail should wait before actually sending your message. You have a few different options. I recommend setting it to the maximum of 30 seconds. Once you configure that, down at the very bottom, make sure to save your changes, and then let's jump back into the inbox. Ooh, look, Patty Fernandez, my manager, can you work over the weekend? No, of course not. So over here, let's click on reply, and here I could enter in my message. Work over the weekend, I'd love to, but my couch already booked me for a very important meeting. I think that's funny. Hopefully she gets the humor. Down here, let's send the message. Now, whenever you send an email, you'll see an undo option pop up in the bottom left-hand corner. If you spot a mistake, you could just click on it. And right over here, I should probably click on undo before those 30 seconds are up. So over here, let's click on undo. And that returns the email message to draft state, and no one ever sees it. It's a simple setting, but it saved me many more times than I'd like to admit. If you ever find yourself typing the same response over and over again, Gmail has a hidden feature that will save you tons of time. Templates. It's also known as canned responses. To enable templates, go up to the top right-hand corner, click on the settings gear, and then see all settings. Let's click into the advanced category, and here you'll see templates. Make sure that's enabled. Then let's go back to the inbox right here. Ooh, look at that. An email asking for the Kevin Cookie Company chocolate chip cookie recipe. You wouldn't believe how many times I get that question every single day. So let's send it one final time, and then we could reuse the response. Over here, I'll click on reply, and now I can paste in the recipe. We have all the ingredients and also the baking instructions. Then in the bottom right-hand corner, we see this three-dot menu with more options. Let's click on that and then click into templates. And over here, we could save the draft as a template. Let's save as a new template. And over here, I'll call this the cookie. Then click on save, and we've now saved a template. Over here, I can now send that out. Now, when we compose a new message, down below, I could click on the three dots, go over to templates, and here, I could insert the cookie template, and that'll place in the ingredients and the baking instructions, saving me time for any future responses to this exact same question. If you want to take things even further, here are a few extra Gmail features that are definitely worth using. And they also happen to be super easy to access. Bonus number one, write your email, and then right next to the send icon, click on this arrow icon, and then select schedule send. This is great for making emails land at the perfect time, say first thing in the morning, or maybe you want to avoid weekend pings. Bonus number two, hover over any email in your inbox, and then right click on it, and then click on snooze, and that'll snooze it until later. This is perfect for deferring things that aren't urgent right now. It'll reappear in your inbox at the time that you select. Bonus number three, confidential mode. When composing an email, at the very bottom, click on the lock and clock icon at the bottom of the window. You can set an expiration date for your email, and you could even require a passcode to open the message. And that's it. Five advanced Gmail tips and tricks with a few bonus tips thrown in. With all that time that you'll save, you can finally reply to that email from 2021. Or not, I won't judge.